Hi friends, in this video I'll talk about earthquakes in Japan. As you might know, Japan is very famous for its earthquakes. But did you know there are about 1500 major earthquakes in a year in Japan? And I'm not even counting the minor ones. So if you count the minor ones, that's almost about a couple of them on a daily basis. In this video, we'll see why Japan is so prone to earthquakes and what the Japanese have done to adapt to these natural disasters. This area is called the Ring of Fire. The Ring of Fire is a region around the Pacific Ocean where there are constant movements and collisions of tectonic plates with one another. As you can see here, the entire country of Japan lies Ring of Fire. And so we have a lot of earthquakes and volcanoes due to these tectonic activities.
日本の地震に関してなんですけど、結構頻繁的に起こってるじゃないですか。それに関して日本人としてはどういう思いですか？そう、びっくりするけど、またかみたいな感じですかね。私は頻繁に起こりすぎて、最初の方はちょっとびっくりして怖かったんですけど、もう慣れてるっていう感じですね。そうですね。なるほど。ちなみに、日本で大きい地震とかの経験ってありますでしょうか？
東日本かな、一番は。あ、あったんですね。その時ってどういう対策とかしたんですか？
対策してなかったですね。
私もいきなり来たんですよ。ああ、なるほど。あんまり対策とかしなかったということですね。日本で結構備蓄品とか、そういった事前準備ってやってるじゃないですか。そういうのをどういうふうにやってらっしゃるんですか？
私はなんか地震がちょっとね、怖かった時があって、なので一応なんかリュックとかに非常食というか、あとは水ですね。水をたくさんなんか段ボールに買って一応置いて、断水した時とかに置いてたり、非常食置いてたり、一応準備はしてます。わかりました。
Even though there are so many earthquakes in Japan, this has not prevented the Japanese from building tall buildings like this one. This is because the Japanese have very strict codes for constructing tall buildings. Most of these buildings have vibration isolators and oil dampers, which can reduce the impulse of an earthquake on the structure. One that needs special mention is this structure right here. It stands at a dizzying 634 meters high and is the second tallest structure in the world, right after Burj Khalifa. Well, that's the sound you never want to hear, especially in the middle of the night when you're fast asleep. These are the cell phone warnings that are automatically sent to your smartphones through the service providers. The funny thing is, you cannot stop them. It only stops when the earthquake stops. Imagine you're in a conference room with 10-15 other people and all the cell phones go bazooka at the same time. It really sends shivers down your spine. They also have the old school loudspeaker systems like this one. These loudspeaker systems are set up on every block and you can even hear them from inside your house. Also in Japan, when there's an earthquake,
all the TV programs are suspended and are switched to live broadcast on TV about the earthquake. Of course, if you have the smartphone, you can download the latest apps which can give you all the latest information about the earthquake. Trains in Japan are super punctual, so much so that you can set the needle on your watch based on the time the train comes to the station. Even such trains can be significantly delayed when there is a big earthquake. So what happens if you're in a train and there is a big earthquake?
We have arrived at Tokyo Teleport Station.
These rails have sensors that pick up the earthquake signals and automatically apply the brakes on trains and bring them to a safe stop. Even the famous bullet trains that travel at around 320 km an hour come to a complete halt due to the advanced earthquake detection systems. During the infamous March 2011 earthquake, there were about 15 bullet trains operating at that time, but all of them came to a safe stop without any derailment. This is hozon shoku. As you can see, it's dry curry flavor. And this is what you get in offices or schools if at all you're stuck because of an earthquake. So let's see what's in there and let's try it out. Yes, and there are two ways of making it, and as you can see, there's a line over here, and if you fill water up till this level, you can make risotto, and if you can fill water up till this level, you can make curry. So well, let's see what else is there on this package. It's 100 grams, it's 376 kilocalories, and at the back, yes, so there's a spoon inside, you can like mix it, and yes, there are two ways to make it actually. You can use hot water if at all you have access to it, and that'll reduce the time to 15 minutes, and if you have normal water, that's also fine. It'll take about 60 minutes to make it. Well, let's go ahead and get started, and I'll rip it open. I'm gonna fill it at 140 ml and then leave it about for 15 minutes because I'm gonna use hot water, and let's taste it and see how it goes.
So, my food is ready, so let's try it out and see how it is. To be honest, it doesn't taste that bad, but that's not the point. It serves a purpose. So, okay, next up is this little guy. Can you understand what it is? I'll give you a hint. Well, it's a radio. Basically, it's a pocket radio which is sent by the ward office to every household in the city. So in case there is an emergency, you can tune into this particular station, which is marked in red. So if you tune into this particular station, you can receive information directly from the ward office on where to evacuate, how to evacuate, and all that stuff. So this little guy is very, very, very helpful. And you have a lot of options too. There's light in it in case it's dark and you need you don't have power, and there's a siren in case you need to call for help or like let other people know that you are stuck somewhere or anything of that sort. Yes, yeah, and one more thing is you have a old school cranking thing which you can crank and charge up your phones. Useful, right? Nice. This is Tokyo Bosai guidebook. So this is also sent by the municipal office to every household in Tokyo. So this is a very comprehensive book of about 300 pages, which has a lot of useful information. So let's see what's in there. There is a probability of 70% that there will be a major earthquake within the next 30 years, right in Tokyo. So are you prepared for it? Well, not completely. And
yes. Okay, one more important thing is, this is the character for Tokyo Bosai. This little guy over here. This is called the Tokyo Rhino. So as you can see, there is a small backpack and he's kind of cute. I think he's kind of scared, but yeah, he has done his homework and he's prepared in case there's an emergency. Okay. The last thing in my arsenal is, this is a disaster kit, and I got this from Amazon for about 3000 yen or $30. It's pretty light, and you can put your passports and other documents in this and just hang it by the door. In case you need to evacuate, just grab it and run. So let's see what's inside this bag. I think this kit is good enough for a person in case of a disaster. They have all the basic necessary items like the aluminum foil, the tissues, the medical first aid kit, the gum tapes, water bottles, cups, and slippers, gloves, torch, the bath towels, plates, and all the other things. Yeah, I think it's good enough for a couple of days. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you liked it, and if you did, leave your likes and the comments in the comment section below. Please subscribe to my YouTube video channel, and I'll bring you more interesting stuff from Japan. For now, it's over and out from Tokyo.